A wonderful good afternoon to one and all. Vivekanand Public School extends a warm and heartfelt welcome to all the school heads, teachers, parents, and students to our inter-school fiesta, Renaissance Expressing Innovations. As the trend goes, this year also, the virtual Renaissance has displayed high fervor, active participation, and amalgamation of daily NCR schools. Today, on the second day of Renaissance 2020, we are presenting you our live event, The Talking Heads. Deliberation and debate is the way you stir the soul of our democracy. So, today we are having brilliant, multi-skilled, and adept scholars from various venerated schools who will compete and share their views about the title, Online Smart Classes Are the Future Education Style. I repeat here, the title is Online Smart Classes Are the Future Education Style. And these participants are going to bring out their hidden aptitude. But before calling the participants, let me introduce the panel of juries who will judge today's contest and select best of the best speakers. Let me introduce our first judge, Ms. Neha Gupta, Deputy General Manager at Pearson. Not only she's been a college topper from Delhi University, but has passion for public speaking and theatre. Neha ma'am, would you like to share a few words with our participants? And do please kindly boost their morale.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It really feels great to be part of this virtual event. This is really a one of its kind experience for me. I mean, this is the first event that I'm attending virtually, which is great. I would just say that, you know, we all understand that these are difficult times, these are very challenging times, and whenever we speak about COVID-19 superheroes, we mostly talk about our medical staff, sanitation staff, policemen, but I would say even our teachers are no less than superheroes, and not just teachers, even our students who quickly adapted to this situation, and, you know, they figured out new ways of teaching and learning. So I would say there's a superhero in each one of us. So it really is a great privilege for me to be part of this event. And without any further ado, I would just wish all the best to all the superheroes out there. All the very best to all the children. Do well and have a great day. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Neha, ma'am. Thanks once again, Neha, ma'am, for your precious words. And definitely these words would have boosted the morale of our participants. Now, let me introduce our second judge for the today's event. She is Mrs. Shilpa Chaudhary, PGT English at Vivekanand Public School, with 20 years teaching experience. And she has grabbed Best Teacher Award twice for her special contribution and excellence in services. Also, she's got third position in Open Delhi Karate Championship. Over to Shilpa ma'am. Shilpa ma'am.
Thank you, Nandini ma'am, and Vande Mataram to all of you. We cannot build the future of our youth, but we can always build our youth for the. I would like to advise all the participants to participate in the true spirit of championship, as the ultimate victory in a competition is derived from your inner satisfaction of whatever you have done your best.
Hence, every participant here is a winner irrespective of the result. So once again, I would like to welcome you all and wish you a very good luck. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Shilpa ma'am. Thank you so much. Thanks for explaining the correct meaning of competition to our participants. That was very important. Now, before we move ahead, let me read out the rules given to the participants. And the participants are requested to follow the rules and regulations. So the rules of the talking heads goes like this. Firstly, all the registered schools have been provided, they have been provided school code like 1A for the favor and 1B against. Participants will have to pin the school code to the costume such that it is visible during the entire performance. The participants should not reveal the identity of the school at any point of time during their performance. Secondly, introduction will be included in the time duration itself. Third is that the participants should be dressed appropriately according to the event as they have already been guided. Fourth, the students will be judged on the basis of these parameters. They are organization and clarity, use of argument, presentation, confidence and body language, time limit. Time limit here, listen carefully, participants. Once again, I would like to make this repeat this thing, that is, the time limit for each participant will be 3 minutes. After 2 minutes, 30 seconds, a warning buzzer will be rung, and at 3 minutes again, there will be second buzzer. So when the first buzzer goes, an alarm should be there. That is a warning for you people that pack up your entire speech. And if the child continue to speak afterwards, then the negative marking will be there. And participants have to keep themselves muted again and again. We have already told you people, again I'm repeating, and I'm requesting you all, the participants and everyone here, to keep themselves muted through the entire time. The participants are going to unmute themselves only at the time of the performance. And last but not the least, that is, our school will be non-competitive here. So now, I can feel this thing, that the participants are all set. I can feel the energy here. So ladies and gentlemen, here we have our first team. So the team number one, and the participants are Tejaswini and Janvi Sethi. Kindly welcome both the participants. Again, I'm repeating, team number one, Tejaswini and Janvi Sethi.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am, sorry to inform you, but we got the link little late. So could you please wait, since I am forwarding my counterpart as well as the link? It would be very kind of you, ma'am.
You have joined late.
Yes, ma'am, we got the link late. So please, ma'am, give us.
I can give you just one team will come and deliver the program. Otherwise, now for the second will be your turn, right?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. It is very kind of you, ma'am.
Welcome. So, judges, please kindly note that as we are having now team number two, because the participants have requested. So we are having now team number two. They are Anshita Bisht and Isha Jain. Anshita Bisht and Isha Jain. Participants, whenever you will speak, you have to unmute yourself and also on your videos. This is the announcement for participants. That is, whenever you are going to speak, you have to unmute yourself and keep your videos on. Thank you. When we take a glimpse into how education imparting techniques have come from ancient gurukuls to modern gurukuls and schools, a common change that we see is the advent of technology. So why not online classes? A very good morning to respected jury and my worthy opponents. I, Anshita, code number 2A, is here to present my views in proposition of the motion, online smart classes are the future education style. When John Lasseter said that the art challenges the technology and the technology inspires the art, we didn't know it was going to hold true in the field of education as well. The offline system of imparting education is truly an art in itself. It kept challenging technology for a longer time in the name of robots can't teach like this. But in the time of pandemic, technology as a silver lining has inspired education system to evolve itself in the form of online smart classes. Let me take you the virtuous cycle that we are going to step into with these online classes. The offline classes where we used to sit in during our live sessions can accommodate only up to like 40 to 50 students at a time. But the future of online classes looks quite promising when it opens up opportunity to a larger section of our population than ever before. Online classes on a global scale put forth the notion of the world is a global village. This using this concept, we can learn anything anywhere from all around the world with teachers all around the globe. For a long imagine of a time where we don't need to travel long distances in those cramped buses. We don't need to be present at a place physically. All we need is a will to study and to be present at a place in a virtual presence. Just think about the time and the money that we are going to save with all these things that we are used to, that we used to spend on the offline classes and the assets required over there. This could help us get over the. This could help us get over the side of getting lethargic and being trapped in a virtual world, thus proving online education an economical aspect. The concept of online education involves education plus technology. With this concept, we would focus not only on universal education, but also on the advantage of studying and teaching anytime, anywhere, as per our pace and scheduling. Online education can also help us build skills and creativity because of the individualized concept of learning and applications of those concepts on a group as a whole. This will improve our functionality and productivity. Let's not be oblivious of the fact that the learning apps like Byju's have proved that the combination of education plus technology can help us develop better understanding and learning. Now, many of my worthy opponents may have a doubt about a lot of people lagging behind in the resources and rich getting richer, poor getting poorer. Dear friend, I have no reason to disagree with you in the present scenario, but where we think of the future, I think the technological advancements will be on a massive scale. Besides, the view of education for all will encourage the government to take steps in favor of those poor people and provide them with all the technology. And this way we can reduce the gap between the rich and the poor. Currently, we are not in a situation where we are used to the virtual environment learning. Huge drawbacks, and that can make us refrain from adopting this system. But we are all humans and we can learn from our mistakes. Thus, all the hurdles we face today may act as stepping stones for developing techniques and technology for better smart classes with better teaching and exam systems. Remember, we cannot give all the knowledge to all the students, but we can provide them with the means to access it. And this vision makes me strongly believe that notion that online smart classes are the future of education style. Thank you.
Thanks so much. Thank you, team two, for sharing your precious words and ideas. But I would like to tell you people that be careful regarding the time limit. Now I would like to call the second team I mean, which is technically our first team, that is team number one. And the participants, again, I'm calling you out, that is Chejaswini and Janvi.
Mom, actually, we have not taken for against.
Okay, let her come then. I waited for her, but when she didn't come, so I started with her. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
You should be fast. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, may I start?
Yes, yes. You can start.
Really? Okay, ma'am. It was really upsetting for me when I saw my brother playing PUBG during his online classes. And then I started thinking that would it be the future education style? Good afternoon to the reverend members of jury, teachers, and my worthy opponents. I'm Isha Jain, code number 2B, is going to oppose the motion. We all know that COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted the education sector globally. Classes have been suspended to enforce social distancing. Recently, the National Education Policy, approved last month, also talks about being ready for digital education. Here, I vehemently oppose this because in India, nearly 3/4 of the students do not have access to internet. And the share of those who didn't have computer-like devices comprises of 89%.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, dear.
Ma'am, can I start again? Because I have network problem.
Everything all right?
Ma'am, I have network problem. That's why I got exit from this meeting.
Okay.
Ma'am, can I start again,
okay.
Please?
Go ahead. Start where you left. Yeah. Just start from where you have left, dear. Isham, you can start from where you have left.
Ma'am, I'm very sorry, ma'am. Very sorry, ma'am. Because of network connection, I don't.
We understand. Start from where you have left.
Today, it was very upsetting for me when I saw my brother playing PUBG during his online classes. And then I started thinking that would it be the future education style? Good afternoon to all the reverend members of jury, teachers, and my worthy opponents. I, code number 2B, hereby to oppose the motion. We all know that COVID-19 pandemic had disrupted the education sector globally. Classes have been suspended to enforce social distancing. In India, nearly 3/4 of the students didn't have access to internet, and the share of those who didn't have the computer-like devices comprises of 89%. So now tell me, why government is promoting that type of education, which is widening the gap between the rich and the poor? Now you will ask how. So to answer, the internet facilities and computer-like devices are related to household incomes. Richer the household, more will be these facilities. Nearly 76% of the method tends to make us remoteness and lack of interaction. According to me, these so-called mobile phones can be used for listening music. But when it comes to writing exams, this is not the ideal medium. I would like to share my personal experience when I saw a boy who never scored well in a class but now scoring the highest marks in the class in the era of 2020. Now I would like to just recall the incidents which occurred last month when two siblings from Delhi University, whose father is a daily wage worker, were worried about their final year exams because their keypad of the phone was not working. Another most distressing example, when a Dalit girl in Kerala kills herself because she was not able to take online classes. My million-dollar question to you all is, did you ever thought about these poor and deprived classes? Don't you think that they also get the chance to shine their future? At last, I conclude that we humans are social animals. We cannot act like machines. Don't you all miss your school, messy classrooms, playing outside in the sunshine, and mainly your motherly advices of teacher and their blissful punishment? A classroom in a lecture in a classroom commands your attention in a way that these videos do not. At last, I want to say that these online smart classes don't must be and should not be the future education style. Thank you and hello.
Okay, thank you Anshita Best and Isha Jain for your lovely performance. Now I call upon team number one, Tejaswini and Janvi Sethi. Tejaswini will be speaking in favor and Janvi will be speaking against the motion.
Ma'am, I'm afraid that's wrong because I would be speaking against the motion and Janvi would be speaking for the motion.
Go ahead, both of you.
Good morning to esteemed judges, honorable guests, teachers and my students. Today, I, Janvi Sethi, feel honored to have been getting the opportunity to speak for the motion. I quote Yuval Noah Harari, who famously said, "Consistency is the playground of dull minds. The world is changing and teaching cannot stay stagnant. We must recognize the fact that the teachers cannot teach the same way they were taught 10-20 years ago. When we are adaptive in our methods and style of teaching, it is then the children are engaged. And when the children are engaged, that is where real learning takes place. It is very important to make education fun, because when it is fun, you don't get kids waking up in the morning and saying, why do we have to attend the same school again? Talking about the impact of online classes on the job rate and the impact it can cause on the powers of the ordinary Homo sapiens in the next few decades, the National Crime Record Bureau report 2018 states that every day 10 people kill themselves due to joblessness and the rate of suicides due to unemployment has increased by 3.6%. The Industrial Revolution in the 19th century created a whole new massive class, the urban working class. And the 21st century revolution will create a whole new massive class, the useless class. Today, we find many people who are unemployed even after getting 100%, top ranks, and studying from renowned universities around the country, just because of their limited knowledge of technology and artificial intelligence. If children will have access to online classes, they will be able to explore the world of artificial intelligence from a much younger age. In a school in Singapore, when students are stuck with certain questions, they post up the questions to their class on social media websites and the classmates respond to it. In my opinion, it is much better because there is more motivation to learn and the children are learning through gadgets they are expert in using and not just pens and pencils. Today, the teachers no longer has a monopoly over the knowledge. Students can acquire knowledge from a myriad of sources and the teachers just need to facilitate them from where they can get the right knowledge and how to synthesize the information that they get. In conclusion, I mean, we should focus on how to leverage the use of technology to improve the classroom instructions. For example, in a class of 40, it is impossible to get 40 students, ask 40 questions at the same time. But when in online classes, we use instant messaging tool, which enables all the students to ask their questions at the same time. In conclusion, I am in no way trying to undermine what a teacher can do for a student. our country, India, has always taken great pride in its students and teachers. Ours is a country of great universities like Nalanda and several other gurukuls where a single teacher was devoted to a handful of students. We should focus on how to make India great again, and the hope lies in its youth. Let's just join hands together and always remember the changes always come with resistance. 200 years of programming cannot change overnight. But what we can do is adopt online classes as the medium of future education. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Now the next participant of team number one.
Ma'am, can you see me? Am I visible?
Yes, you can start ahead. You can start ahead.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I just really feel very honored to have been given this opportunity to speak against the topic Online Smart Classes are the Future Education Style. While my co-mate, Janvi, well emphasized the fact that we need to accept and adapt to the change of online classes. I am all in for a change, but what I am against is that online smart classes becoming a complete fixture in the future education style. Moreover, I hope that you all will appreciate my points that I am going to substantiate from my side. Education style from the very beginning of the era has been multidimensional and dynamic. What I mean by this, that education does not only acquaint us with subject matter of concerns, but also with many other things. For example, how to show the better side of the personality, how to develop social competence, how to respect time, and also how to be disciplined, and so on. Also, education emphasizes the point that physical exercise is also necessary with mental exercise. Healthy mind resides in a healthy body. This statement lies very up here. Moreover, education gives us a platform where students can exhibit their practical knowledge, where they can interact with nature and social beings, and thus eradicate the differences the society possesses at now. Moreover, this all education is covered in traditional schooling style. Also, while I appreciate the fact that my counterpart, Janvi, mentioned that online smart class provides a platform where each and every student gets equal opportunity to have the opportunity to get attended to their doubts and get answer to their doubts in a consolidated way, I personally feel that this can be done by the simple aid of technological advancement in the present existing offline education style as well. Moreover, this education style, the online smart classes, from 3 months or so we have attended, we also have found the loopholes in it. That is, we get itchiness in our eyes and we get angst due to extended screen time. Also, we are becoming multitaskers in a negative sense. That is, we are juggling with different things at the same time. Also, the shift of education from economically and technologically backward states and areas to economically advantaged states and area is also observed. Also, we are becoming indisciplined and competence is not seen, because I believe that competence is developed by the knowing of competition. Also, I feel that let's just hope that this crisis comes to an end and we revert to our former schooling system with the aid of technological assistance. Also, I would like to conclude now that online smart classes leads to the production of robots and not social and conscious human beings. Thank you and have a nice day.
Applaudable performance indeed. Team one, it was
thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Now, calling upon our next team, and this is team number three. And the participants are Ishita Jain and Gorvi Nagpal. Team number three, Ishita Jain and Gorvi Nagpal.
Yes, ma'am. Can you see me, ma'am?
Yes, yes. You can start with.
Sometimes we win and sometimes we learn. And we all know that this is not a winning situation. With warm rays to sunshine, I, Gauri Nagpal, would like to wish the judges and all the listeners a very warm good afternoon. The COVID-19 pandemic has greatly disrupted various aspects of normal life. Globally, over 1.2 billion children are away from the privilege of sitting and learning in their classroom. As a result, the global education system had to take some major steps. Schools have foregone traditional classes and shifted to online classes. Online learning, which came as the panacea for the crisis, is increasingly seen as a new paradigm in education. Firstly, I would like to highlight how convenient online classes are. They are truly time saver, and students can now focus on other productive activities as well, which means the knowledge can now be enhanced just at the comfort levels of their homes. Okay, so now you must be wondering, what about learning? Well, I feel that there haven't been a better learning experience than this. From interesting features, videos, to images and documentaries, online education has indeed been a blessing. It enhances retention power among students, and remembering things was never made easier. As soon as the pandemic broke out, there was a havoc in the education system. Students and teachers were both worried on their part. How will the assignments be taken? How will the projects be submitted? How will the tests be conducted? But without a doubt, online learning feature has provided a wide and stable platform for all the teaching learning community to connect. It is rightly said by Mr. Wong Tao, Vice President of Tencent Education, I believe that the integration of information technology in education will be further accelerated and that online education will become an integral component of school education. Well, I should not forget to mention this, that there are few glitches in the online education. But with technology advancing each day, we can be sure that in no time, these glitches would be taken care of. In my opinion, even in the midst of pandemic, we have been successfully able to create a perfect teaching learning model that proved wrong all the myths that said learning could not sustain online. So questioning something that has proved itself to be a knight in the shining armor would be very wrong. Thank you.
Next participant, please. Team number three, online, the next participant.
Online smart classes are the future education style? Really? No. I have a different say on this. I, Ishika Jain, wish you all a very warm afternoon. Educational style can be molded into any way, be it online or offline classes. Undoubtedly, online classes have made it possible to connect the students and teachers globally, and also it has made possible the teaching learning process at this time where it is very important to practice social distancing. But if we consider the wider picture and look upon the future, this learning style will not be able to establish itself as a beneficiary model. Primarily, talking about the reach of these online classes, the statistical data shows that nearly 68.8% of the population of our country is poor, which means that these people do not have any access to this process and that they are completely alien to the world of technology. Let's face it, buying a smart device, establishing an internet connection is not a cheap deal. Also, these devices are very fragile and not easy to operate. Not everybody is technologically well-versed. From training teachers to ensuring that each and every student is taught effectively incurs some very high costs. Such a wide learning platform has numerous drawbacks to it. Technical glitches hamper the teaching learning process. online learning will eventually affect both physical and mental health of the children. It is right to say that online learning deprives the students of the benefits of being in a healthy classroom. Neither let them have any face-to-face interaction, nor the feel of benches, blackboard, playground. Absence of classmates precludes discussion and communication among peers. Adding further, the workload has built upon the shoulders of the teachers. Searching for relevant videos, preparing presentations involves huge amount of effort on the part of the teachers, and it becomes difficult for them to take out time for their own families. Contradicting the fact of online classes possessing new features, both students and teachers find this method boring since there is no real interaction. Now, throwing some light on the difficulties faced in this process, conducting of exams has never been more difficult. Attempting on the part of students and checking on the part of students has never been more complex. Considering all the above drawbacks, do you still think these online classes as the future of education? Do you want this kind of future for yourself? Online classes are similar of being in a cage, and you don't want to be in a cage, right? Well, according to me, all these points are very much enough to justify the fact that future that online classes cannot be the future of education system. Thank you.
Mesmerizing performance indeed. I'm sure everyone who is a part of this program agrees to this. I'm amazed how nicely and enthusiastically these students are putting up their views at this platform. Really applaudable. And with the same energy, I call team number 4, Priyanshi Gupta and Lavisha. Priyanshi Gupta,
yes, ma'am.
And Lavisha, team number 4.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes. Yes, dear, you are audible.
Okay, ma'am.
And visible.
Life isn't a Burger King. You can't always have it your way, right? Well, the COVID-19 pandemic has had a great impact on the way children learn. The teaching landscape has shifted from the notion of a singular path towards a much more basic understanding of how we have to walk the tightrope between the online and the offline learning. And quite suddenly, teachers in the classroom are learning to liberate, benefit, and redistribute learners through technology. Good afternoon, everyone. Today, I, Priyanshi Gupta, Code 4A, hold the chair to discuss the need of an hour. Online smart classes are the future education style. Persons would give us smart development. So I ask you all, should we take it as an opportunity? Well, yes, I think we should. To start with, students have the freedom to juggle with their careers and schools because they aren't tied down to a fixed schedule. Generally, in a traditional classroom setting, meeting time was set and the student has no power over this, forcing them to work their schedule around these dates. But most students who consider this mode of learning have other commitments also and prefer this as it gives them power over how they delegate their time towards a different project. And all the information you will ever need will be safely stored in an online database. That means things like live discussion documents, emails, or even training materials can be easily accessed with just a click of mouse, saving the valuable time. Also, it empowers us for global learning. Well, this kind of education has grown over the last few years and has experienced a mainstream acceptance with an online class to control your learning environment, which eventually helps you discover your true self. Today, we're stuck with COVID-19, and God knows what tomorrow holds for us. So why not having a standard mode that is the online smart classes and mastering it to change the methods time and again and bluffing with the courage of the students? As we all know, that new modes of learning are always springing up in the market, providing students with an opportunity to fashion their education into something that fits them, not the other way around. Well, The future of online education looks quite promising. So we as individuals shouldn't let the situation of time and space ruin our learning. Online education is like a rising tide. It's going to lift all the boats high, right? Let's together build a community of learners in smart classes. Thank you very much. Over to you, Lavisha.
Well, worst by my opponent. But I hold a different perspective. To you, I question. Aren't we defaming the teaching standards? Imagine a clever getting his online training in archery. A very warm and auspicious good morning to everyone present over here. Today, Lavisha Bagheja, code number 4B, presents before you the catapulted side of the coin named online education. With the invasion of virus worldwide, online education has lent a helping hand. But using this technology in years to come as spam. Online education irrefutably saved our drowning year. Teachers' perennial saga of hard work is perfectly justified. But how can one forget the fostering environment that the school provides? Education is not just getting known to some discovered facts that the teacher repeats. It's an interaction one shares with the peers, which help us set out our branches and let us blossom. But this online education uses internet as their muscles to build a wall between our social environment, separates us from that uncanny wisdom. How could one feel that this would prove to probe the unfathomed possibilities of collated growth? One, under the aegis of teachers, learns to grow, to reach the pinnacle. How would they now be able to impregnate us with the chivalrous leadership for shaping the impeccable city of India? Question yourself. Is it giving satisfactory results in the remote areas where Wi-Fi stations are not established? Allow me to mirror you to the urban areas where teachers, the handholders, are encountered with numerous abuses and other pleasantries. School sets on a voyage of exploration. But this online education stimulates the cultivated mindset. One would be in an arena of few acquaintances, helping reproduction of the same thinking specimens. There'll be end of that innovation and new phrases. And this would debar us from our child prodigy. We lost many of our Einstein. To the guts, I believe, this is a paid companion with personality development classes. Because pursuing this in long run would void our ability of speaking out loud in public. We fear being there on the stage to be the protagonist of our own story, to face the ills of the society. Moreover, it holds a skeptical approach toward punishment. It would snatch teachers' power to nurture and transform us, as incited from the Dronacharya's time. The Guru Kuli. Your faults be available for me to learn. Reaching the end of my sources, moving online gives a profound sense of loss. The loss of standard of education. But still, if my opponent justifies the unjustifiable stance, then sorry. Sorry, Eklavya. Gone are the thumb-cutting days. I think I should rest my voice over here. Thank you. Ma'am, I'm done.
Wonderful. Well done, team number 4. You both were too good at it. Now, team number 5, our next team. And the participants are Pakhi and Avni Sharma. Pakhi and Avni Sharma from team number 5.
Corona or no corona? The shift to online smart classes was inevitable. Let's just say Corona may just have acted as a catalyst. Good afternoon, respected judges and my fellow thinkers. I, Avni Sharma from team number 5, stand for the motion that online smart classes are the future education style. One can't deny the fact that the concept of traditional education has changed radically within the last couple of years. Being physically present in the classroom isn't the only learning option anymore. Not with the rise of the internet and new technologies at least. We are now entering a new era, the revolution of online education. From traditional classroom teaching to online teaching, from carrying heavy books in our bags to having numerous PDFs in our devices, from blackboards to interactive whiteboards. Even if not for COVID-19, this change had to happen. Being able to learn online provides you with the freedom to learn wherever you are. It is often more convenient for people because you don't have to sacrifice a large chunk of your day to commute or stuck in traffic. Online learning means that you can learn from the comfort of your own home. And don't we all want that? It shouldn't be hard to accept the notion of leaving behind the conventional classroom teaching if it's to face this vast space called the internet. A host of information is just a click away, as students can simply look up into any topic across the search engine. In the modern age, technology has entered every nook and corner of human life and has proved to bridge the gap between traditional learning and fun-filled learning. Instead of worrying whether or not online education can ever be as good as more traditional formats, we should instead focus on how we can use it to deliver quality education for people all over the world, particularly for the poor and undeserved. Let's say a remote corner of the country where no good teacher wants to go. Well, get them internet and voila, they have a teacher now, thanks to the online smart classes. My dear opponents, technology can become the wings that will allow the educational world to fly farther and faster than ever before. We need technology in every classroom because at the end of the day, it is the lens through which we experience most of our world. Thank you, and over to you, Pakhi.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, Bika.
Okay, so shall I start?
Yes,
Bika. Around 70% of the Indian population lives in less than $2 a day, which is approximately 150 rupees. Multiply that by 30, which is their monthly income, and that is how much you and I sometimes spend on one dinner. Are you wondering I'm reading out these calculations to you? Well, that is because it's important for you and I to recognize our privilege, to understand how lucky we are, and to also understand that there are so many people across the world who do not have the same privilege. 1 in 4 Indian children are not in school right now. 99 million Indian children dropped out of school according to the census conducted in 2011. So while the idea of online education becoming the new education style is in fact very beautiful, it unfortunately is not very inclusive. Good afternoon to one and all present here. Today I, Pakhi Bharanwal, am here to firmly oppose the motion that online smart classes are the new future education style. I'm not going to deny the fact that online classes have in fact been our savior during this pandemic and have helped us in a lot of ways because of two reasons. One, we can access them from the convenience of our own home. Two, we can access them whenever we want. But the problem lies in the fact that most people across India, a majority of our population, does not have access to the internet. They, most of all, do not even have homes in the first place, which I think all of us are failing to acknowledge. There are so many people who actually live in streets. Now, the coronavirus pandemic has done more than just halt us from going on with our daily lives. It has made the economy go on a downhill. Millions of people across the world, and especially in our nation, have lost their jobs. So the issue of unemployment has gone up by even more. People do not even have the money to put food in their stomach. The idea of buying a mobile phone or an electronic device is a paradox they cannot even afford to think about. Now, hypothetically, even if the government does provide all of these people with an electronic device, what guarantee can we give that when they do need the money, they're not going to sell the mobile phone to put food in their stomach? Or even beyond that, to think in the first place that the 200 million people in our country who do not have access to electricity will be able to access the internet. How absurd is that idea? Now, getting to children have a very limited attention span. They do not pay attention to studies very well as it is. And to expect them to sit in front of a device without teacher supervision and to actually listen without any distractions is not very believable to me because you and I, we ourselves are very, very big examples. So I'm going to end with something I wrote right now while listening to all the participants. To believe that butterflies can fly is in fact a very alluring idea. But the truth of the matter is, unless and until they have the skills to form a cocoon, our belief remains nothing but our neglect. Thank you.
Great, great speaking skills, team number five. How wonderfully you people have shared your views. Applaudable indeed. And now moving to the team number six. And our next participants of team number six are Simran Chopra and Apurja Tyagi. Arujya Tyagi. That is Simran Chopra and Arujya Tyagi from team number six.
Am I audible and visible, ma'am?
Yes, dear.
Thank you. The only person who is educated is the one who has learned how to learn and change. A very good afternoon, judges, teachers, and my fellow participants. This pandemic made us experience what we wouldn't have imagined of experiencing, and one of them was the online classes. In this utterly hopeless time, online classes came to the rescue of students so that they don't get behind and proved us the meaning of a very famous phrase. Life goes on. Now, at one point, we are talking about digital cash, digital payments, and what not, even digital India. So why not digital education? Why to just completely turn our faces away from a different aspect of a broader category? It's a human tendency to get comfortable with one thing and just abstain from the idea of something taking us out of our comfort zones. I want to ask all of you that haven't we all taken a shift from something traditional to a more technology-based alternative? From going to buy tickets from a counter to book my show, from matchmakers to shadi.com, from going to buy clothes from a shop to Myntra, Flipkart, etc. Changes need to happen. Minds need to get more open. Traditional learning provides the optimum form of learning. Now, this is the most brought up argument when the question of online education comes, and even after keeping with the online classes is the way or not argument aside, this statement is blatantly wrong. As once Benjamin Bloom, an educational psychologist, did an experiment on different types of learning techniques, and he found traditional learning is the least effective of them all, and said, you can't expect every child to take the same amount of time to achieve the same objective, as a child may be a fast learner or a slow learner. On the other hand, online education is so diverse, and it's not just limited to certain topics and subjects, which can't be said about traditional learning. Now, if you're asked to eat a favorite dish, but daily, for the 2-3 days, you'll love it. But then the following days, you'll like it. But then, a day is going to come when you can't even stand the smell of that dish. So if you can't expect anyone or even yourself to eat the same dish daily, how can a student be expected to not get bored while studying in the same education system for years? So what we all should do is pause for a second. Think for a minute. And then again, play the play buttons of our lives, because the time for pause, rewind, and speed up is here. Thank you and have a nice day. And then, ma'am.
The next, so Malcolm, the next X, participant of this team. Yeah.
So Malcolm X once said, education is a passport to the future, for tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for it today. Insightful, isn't it? However, it raises a question, or perhaps two in my mind. Is online education system really preparing us for our tomorrow? Or if adopted, will it prepare our future generations for their future? Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Today we have gathered to ask this question and reflect upon ourselves and our choices. As a student, I am not really a big fan of online classes. Yes, at first they were quite enticing as teachers taught us using videos and presentations. But after sitting through roughly 514 hours of online classes, the spark of it is gone. My fellow students talked about how they're entertaining and innovative. But doesn't everything have an end point? The monotony of online classes has thus pushed students into an abyss of helplessness. But helplessness, how? Without gadgets, there is this persistent feeling of being lost. With teachers providing us with every possible pre-written study material, our students are losing the exhilarating feeling of missing lessons and then covering them up totally on our own. This brings us to our next agenda. With teachers spoon-feeding us, students are losing their cognitive functioning. The HMS 2019 studies had already proven that prolonged screen time reduced cognitive functioning, shorten attention spans, bring chronic neck and back pain, and impair our vision. It is only now that us students at a tender age are experiencing the symptoms of a shorter lifespan. The elders amongst us now must agree with me that online classes not only wreak havoc on students, but on teachers and school administrators as well. It must be a tedious and cumbersome job for teachers to keep track of who all are understanding the concepts that are being taught in class. Technical hiccups also take up a lot of valuable teaching time. During network disruptions or malfunctions in hardwares and or softwares, teachers have to cancel their classes altogether. In conclusion, online classes cannot be the future style of education. However, they can be a part of it. For me, online classes will always be like a seasonal vacation. And we all know vacations cannot be the style of life. Thank you.
Thank you, team number six. Wonderful again. One of the participants reminded us of our favorite dish. And the another one recalled an old proverb that is, tomorrow belongs to those who prepare for today. Wonderfully shared your views. Now over to team number seven. And our participants are Kamya and Vanshika. Team number seven, participants Kamya and Vanshika.
I dream of a digital India where quantity education reaches the most inaccessible corner driven by digital learning. A very frantic morning to one and all present here. I am Kamya of team number 7 and we all are presented here to share our views on topic online smart class are for the future education style. And I will be speaking in favor of the motion. And the quote that I said right now was said by a respectable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji. A smart class is conspicuous with a bunch of active students glued to various digital gadgets to pursue holistic education. Online classes enables the teacher and the students to pursue their online smart classes enables the teacher and the students to set their agenda. It enables the teacher and the students to study or teach from anywhere in the world. For example, we can see many of our students, many of our friends too, stuck in their hometown in these days of pandemic of COVID-19, but still they are able to attend classes. Only because of the online classes, which is a blessing in disguise. In online classes, we have access to diverse study materials such as videos, ebooks, PPTs, etc. In the famous word of Maxim, we have read, a picture is worth of 1,000 words. I repeat, a picture is worth of 1,000 words. It is through online classes that students can see a picture or a video and will be able to assimilate all the information that will be in all the information through the via these tools. In this, no transport is required as there will be less transport means less pollution. In this, we need an internet connection and a cost-effective method. all this surely proves that online education is the future of education. All this surely proves that online education is the future of education, that none of us can disagree with this, that these online classes have made us innovators, imaginators, creators, and better learned students. Thank you and have a nice day.
Very good afternoon to everyone. I am Vanshika from team number 7. We are here to present a debate on online classes for our future education style. I do not agree with the idea of having online classes for the education system. There are such as so many demerits. Little or no face-to-face interaction. While this may seem obvious, students have a tendency to underestimate the never meeting the teacher and the other students. And student online education creates a monologue and not a real dialogue in the learning environment. Building relationship with your teacher and classmates will require more effort in an online environment. It is work for the students. Online courses typically require a greater amount of reading and assignments than traditional classes. Programs in general are improving the quality of their online courses, and this means that students will have to do more proof that they have mastered the material. It is more work for the parents, especially also those with small kids. Parents have to sit with children of primary classes. Intense requirement for self-discipline. Online courses usually have deadlines for assignment, test, etc. That's not the problem. The problem is that the time management of organization, skills necessary to stay on top of your homework. Your work allot an appropriate amount of time to complete each task and balance your coursework against the priorities in your life. If you tend towards, then you might need to strengthen your skill set before choosing an online course or program. E-learning cannot replace the knowledge that comes through hand-to-hand experience. Lack of practice-based learning, online learning, often theory-based class practice learning. Thank you.
Wonderful. Wonderful performance again. Now coming to moving to the next team, that is team number 8, and the participants are Pratishtha Chaudhary and Nishant Kotra. Team number 8, Pratishtha and Nishant.
Ma'am, shall I start?
Yes, dear.
Okay. Technology will not replace great teachers, but technology in the hands of great teachers can be revolutionary. Good afternoon. Today, I, Pratishtha, Code 8A, am here to present my views for the motion on the topic, Online Smart Classes are the Future Education Style. The current academic session is an extraordinary one. The educational field, in particular, has undergone a sea change as the world is trying to build up resilience against the pandemic. With schools switching to online teaching, there has been a boom in the e-learning business. At the very outset, I would like to remind my opponents that we are all digital natives and online learning is going to be a life skill in the near future. Willingly or unwillingly, we are all a part of the process of developing new and permanent backup systems redesigned to meet the needs which have been exposed in the crisis. There have always been large gaps in students' learning opportunities due to their economic backgrounds. Today, India is leading the digital revolution with speed and scale. Online classes can definitely be the medium to make education equally accessible to all, delivering opportunities for learning and growth. Some of the greatest universities of the world are also offering their courses online, cutting across social, economic, and cultural differences. Online education helps students in becoming active rather than passive learners while taking full responsibility for their own studies. It also encourages them to express their ideas without any inhibitions, enabling them to think creative, big, and ahead. Each student learns and memorizes differently. Online classes encourage the students to learn at their own pace, as they can easily revisit the concept taught previously multiple times to develop a deeper understanding. Online classes offer great flexibility, as students can log into the course at a time that works best for them. In my opinion, online education is not only student but also environment friendly. With cost-effective learning materials that are being digitally published and distributed and also available at one place, online education saves the cost of cutting down trees to production of paper, to printing, to packaging and shipping. Most of us can vouch that e-learning has enabled education to upgrade their content. The switch to online learning may be difficult, but it is definitely rewarding. The fact that we all are here in an online competition is a proof that gradually we all have embraced the idea of online classes, and we shall only move ahead. Thank you. Over to you, Nishant.
Yes, ma'am. Education is not acquired by listening to words, but through experiences that transform the mind. Greetings to everyone present here today. I am Nishant Gotra. I'm here to oppose the motion that online smart classes are the future education style. The COVID-19 pandemic has led to a never before anticipated restructuring of education system, where online smart classes are now substituting regular schooling. But can we really vouch for its reach, relevance and impact to that extent that we call it the future of education system? At its core, teaching responds to encounters and shared human feelings. A major part of education is encouragement and empowerment, and to do so requires both educators and peers to express themselves. Online classes lack these face-to-face interactions, which are essential for social and intellectual development. Online classes have dramatically increased the screen time of learners. A research showed that children with more than 6 hours of screen time have experienced thinning of the brain's cortex, a part of brain responsible for critical and reasonable thinking. Online smart classes have also lowered the physical activity levels of students, making them stationary hours on end in front of their screens. We can all agree on one thing, that it is getting more and more difficult to focus on our studies due to an increase in distractions. And there is no way to tell that the students are actually conducting and learning in the classes, and the assessment of their learning becomes even more challenging. Education is a right of every child, but the very idea of online education makes it out of reach of those who do not have enough money to buy technology necessary for online education. One thing is one important point, that there is no fees difference between education on the campus and online education, and there are no tests and labs being done, making the children lack the experiential learning. I think online education is the best thing we can do right now, but saying that it is the future of education is an idea far-fetched from reality, as it would require sacrifices that I'm sure even my worthy opponents are not ready to make. Thank you.
Great speaking skills, Pratishtha and Nishant. Wonderful again. Wonderful performance by this team also. Now coming to the next team, and the participants are Anirudh and Pragya. Team number 9, and they are Anirudh and Pragya.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yes, beta.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I, Anirudh Damani of code 9A, stand firmly for the motion. In the ancient world, claiming that the earth revolves around the sun was blasphemous. In 2019, claiming that online education would be the key to future could be called crazy. Today, it is evident that the earth is revolving around the sun and global education is revolving around computers. My question to you all today is that, is online education the answer to blending schools and practical empowering learning? I believe it is. Our old schooling system is turning old school. We have customized phones and customized cars. Online gives us customized classes. It is not some low-grade clerical job which we've been doing till now. It's a springboard of ideas. If I know what I'm good at and work on it at my pace, I want to learn and I'm not made to learn as in a typical classroom. It may be called online, but it honors human diversity, curiosity, and creativity. You all must have heard of the online convocation held by IIT Bombay. I just want to tell this to my opponents. Stop living in the past. 10 years from now, add or subtract a few, when your degree would be reduced to a piece of paper, when imagination would be the most powerful nation, and when artificial intelligence will creep in every domain, we would race towards an advanced ecosystem. And your traditional schools will fade to oblivion by a galaxy created by 5G, by robots, by data analysis. We humans are designed to create universes, and the passport of our future is only available online. Dear jury, this can wipe out all layers of separation, as even if I'm from Nigeria, I can get an online diploma from Harvard. It can have a staggering effect on the social fabric by pouring colors of learning into the lives of specially abled individuals and many others not specially able, still unable to attend school. The learning curve will bounce as higher education will be available for one and all. Interaction, check. Dropout rates, check. Safety, check. You name it, it has it. You can question me, but not research. In a popular university survey, 90%, yes, 90% of all attendees voted for online schooling. Some people must be feeling lonely here, but online classes, they are not the future. They're not a future style. They are the future itself. In the end, I would like to say, schools and education blend when children don't compete, but create. When teachers treat each student as a miracle. And when people from corners of the world become lifelong learners. The catalyst is online schooling, and the result is a society ridden by a century-old rigid system, which doesn't only mute mouths, my friends, but also minds. Thank you. Over to Pragya.
Hello, ma'am. Before beginning, I'd like to clarify if my visibility and audibility is vivid to one and all.
Yes. Yes, Pragya, it's very much clear.
May I start, ma'am?
Yes. Yes, dear.
Few years down the lane, I don't see kids running to their bus stops, making small talks with their classmates, or for that matter, coercing the teacher for a free period. All I see is the deceptive umbrella of online classes, which is constraining the children to software interfaces as they socialize from their homes with bubbled up personality. Good morning, everyone. I, Pragya Parmita, quote 9B, stand firmly against the motion. Dear jury, we don't want our posterity to be digital Napoleon, because all they would conquer are zeros and ones. The new education policy expects the pedagogy to make education well-rounded, which is only viable through physical proximity with the people, not screens, and certainly not by turning off their senses. The need of the hour is to build bridges, not walls, or else we'll soon enter into a race between exposure and isolation. After years of debating, today I feel extremely helpless and uncomfortable. My movements are restricted, eye contact narrowed, posture defined. This is how our lives have been enclosed in Microsoft Windows. Online education would turn us all into shut-ins, and it would ultimately put a nail in a coffin of bad output by ending the dichotomy between progressive schools and conservative ones. Have my worthy opponents ever mused upon the fact, why do we need schools? It is because a society is marked dysfunctionally into all sorts of social compartments. But it is the school where a child is taught principles like equality, fraternity, and a sense of sharing, where reformation takes place through socialization, by learning a myriad of emotions. Please understand that school is not a spectator sport, so let the students play. I fail to understand what kind of social inclusiveness my opposition is talking about. Concepts like midday meal that incentivize the poor towards education will be dissolved. Why are they turning a blind eye towards the upcoming digital divide, which would lead to the collapse of egalitarianism? Need I remind my dear opponent that India is a signatory to the Article 16 of the UNCRC? Rigid surveillance infringes the privacy, self-expression, and autonomy of a child. Privacy is dead, and online education holds the smoking gun. Online education may provide teachers, but it can never provide guns. We children would much rather be surrounded by walls that hold memories, create a connection with the humanity, than be held together by screens which damage not our eyesight, but our vision. Thank you.
Thank you, team number 9. I was just wondering how perfect these students are, these young minds are in putting up their ideas and arguments, and that too so impressively. Wonderful.
Thanks a lot,
a huge round of applause for all the participants present here. Moving ahead, we have team number 10, and the participants are Riddhima Saraswat and Abhinandan Kumar Rai. Team number 10, Riddhima Saraswat and Abhinandan Kumar Rai. Are you there, team number 10?
Ma'am, I am here. My waiting for my companion.
Yes, ma'am, we both are very much here.
Okay, go ahead.
Am I visible?
You are not audible clearly, Bita. Abhinandan, you can tell me what she wants to say, if you know.
Ma'am, she is saying, actually, she's starting with this debate, with her debate only. I think she is starting soon. Dean, you may start.
If you are not
audible now.
Should I start, ma'am?
Yeah, start. You can start, Abhinandan.
Okay. Educating the mind without educating the heart is no education at all, stated by Aristotle. Now, good afternoon, everybody. Here is Abhinandan Kumar Rai, quote number 10B, in front of you to go over my topic in the Against the Motion, Online Smart Classes is the Future of Education Style. Let me take a sticky point. Today, modern technology is replacing everything. We do not need paper and pen as we can write over software. We do not need books because of the advent of ebooks and PDFs. Now the question arises, can this modern technology replace teachers too? The answer of the above one is a big no. Everyone has different perception. From my point of view, the answer of the above one is a big no, because teachers are much important for a child to teach than a machine. Taking critical skills into account, like decision making, time management, etc., etc., a child needs a teacher, because teacher is more important. Even we are going to run this competition. We are running this competition with such enthusiasm because of our anchor, who is a teacher also, Miss Nidhi Sareen. Hands off you to ma'am. Hands off to you. Now, I am stating that there are many points that state that online smart classes should not be the future of education style. It includes costly affair, technical hiccups, distraction issues, environmental issues, etc. Let me elaborate some of them. Starting with technical hiccups and answering to Gauri Nagpal, to the point she stated that this technology and these online classes are time saver. Is it so? A minor breakdown in smart boards take hours to repair. A minor breakdown in software take days to repair. Conclusion is that these online classes, these so-called online classes, should not be the future of our education style. Now, the second point that I want to state of the today's condition, my every favorable companion is stating that today we are able to learn only through online classes, even in this pandemic. My dear friends, I also know, and you also know very clearly, that we are learning today through these online classes because of the condition, not of our will. And each and everyone is just thinking that when their classroom opens and they should enter there and learn there. Second point to be noted over here, dealing with the problem that excessive use of gadgets by teachers and by students also. Students are distracting through this. They are not using that gadgets that which are provided to them for studies. They are moving on another path. Now, actually, 3 minutes is not sufficient for stating the points, the demerits of these online classes, smart classes mentioned. Will be companion again, that will be much better. Ending with a shlok that akhand mandala karam vyaptam yen characharam tat padam darshitam yen sri guruve nama. Thank you very much. Thank you. Have a nice day ahead.
That's Ridhima is going to speak now.
Ma'am, am I audible and visible to you now?
Yes. Now it's clear, Bachi.
Okay, should I start now?
Yeah, sure.
Imagine the learning irrespective of place. Imagine the learning irrespective of time. Imagine the learning irrespective of hard copies. Imagine the learnings of the future generations, the learnings online. Good afternoon to a generation despite having books. And a a tortoise, isn't it? Yes, of course. We all want to be tasking, and we are on travels just to get weekends achieved as and without waiting. Yes, generations online classes, the future of new education. Generations of online classes are the flexibility given by online. Flexibility makes a perfect and study the wide set of programs. The set of programs online classes provide are too much. From instrumental learning to quantum physics, any kind of education can be learned from this online classes, getting official degrees, certificates, or diploma. Now is accessibility. Let's just thank this pandemic, various NGOs, and are working in the field of rural areas. Then we give the rural area education, but also an access to which will ultimately make it much more smarter in terms of the people. All reasons why time is very much saved. Smaller than the
Well, in the last, I just want to say that no matter, there are so many things that in which education online is lagging, but it doesn't mean it is not good. It is still the best way for online education. And in the children not agree, then let me take for the question I asked, but somewhere yet. Thank you.
Thank you, team number 10. Over to our next team, team number 11, and they are Supreet Singh and Abbas Ali. Supreet Singh and Abbas Ali.
Hello, ma'am.
That is team number 11. Team number 11, Supreet Singh and Abbas Ali.
Excuse me, ma'am. Am I audible as well as clear at the same time, if I ask you?
Yeah, you are audible very much, and the picture is also clear. You can go ahead.
Ma'am, before starting, I must ask the jury members to turn on their video because their expressions matter more to me. Can it be possible?
You can pin on their, their videos on. All right. That is your request to the jury. Let's see.
Thank you, everyone, for listening to me. So, may I start?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. The payment towards success is getting right thing at the right time. Hello everyone, the jury members, counselors, and the live audience. My team welcome you for joining us today. Online learning is not the next big thing, it is now a big thing. Keeping this in mind, I, Supreme Code 11A, feel immense pleasure to deliver my thoughts and opinion on the topic Online Smart Classes, a Leap to the Future. I, being in favor of this topic, presents you myself with a great network coverage. Challenges and the need to overcome them help to find new ways of learning things. So does this online learning. It's not less than a blessing for students in this post-COVID situation. My fellow mates, am I clear? My fellow mates, mentioning the effects of this is many and many, much and more. That it is to be a great and flexible system for students as well as teachers, as it provides an own base to work on, which is quite well, and it can be accessed from anywhere in the world. It also offers a wide variety of selective and competitive programs, which cannot be fitted in an entire room or can say entire web. These competitive programs, which of course are not available at AKA the old traditional book learning platforms, which help in the technological advancement of creative minds. And it would not be wrong to say that this is leading to the evolution of mankind. It's accessible, like we are in a meeting. It's accessible. You can sign in any class or room from anywhere, anyhow, anytime, and if missed, recordings are always available, which is quite well and necessary for me too. It also allows the students to get a well-created and customized learning experience, which at least increase the interest to get indulged into it for anyone who uses this. You, me, they, yeah, and everyone, anyone who uses it. And keeping the parents' perspective, lastly, the most important factor, affordability. Believe it or not, but it is as affordable as a monthly installment between 1 to 2,000 INR, which is quite low as compared to heavy lifting bags and constantly study, costly study materials. They don't stand a chance here. Someone beautifully stated, what can't be cured must be endured to live with. Leaving the decision to you all, for all the motion must stand or fall, I stand in favor of this topic. Thank you.
Yes, Bachi, yes.
Ma'am, am I audible to you? Okay, ma'am.
Sure.
So, ma'am, shall I start?
Necessity is the mother of invention, but everything in this world comes with a price and certain consequences. And are we ready to pay that price? Taking this into account and my fellow mates' view, I, SM Abbas Ali, quote 11B, in the presence of jury, I want to forward cutthroat opinion to my companion's view. Dear opponent, I don't know if flexibility that you meant by this system was a new opportunity for students to stop killing dreams of their grandfather and grandmother for the sake of a day off and giving them a new set of excuses like, sorry, my net is not working properly. Or on the other hand, student, I need to submit assignment before 6 in the evening, even on Sundays. I hope this flexibility won't tangle things more instead. And next was the technology advancement, huh? Oh my, what kind of technological advancement is this, my friend, which suddenly comes in like an ad in movie theater while studying online? Quite shocking, right? To think solving value of cos theta, an answer comes up, dil bechara. This is one of the reasons I'm opposing online system where entertainment and schooling collides. Again and again, mate, we heard in news, see ourselves about poor people who are stating it is, and you are stating it is easily accessible. Please don't joke around. People don't get food for days. How come they will get smartphone for online classes? Leave recording aside. So let me restate it for you. It is on heartwarming school moments. I really don't think that any amount of money can buy all of that. Taking time in dear friends, I was not lagging. It was just a specimen of interruption which generally happens in online classes. Taking time into consideration, I would like to wrap up my case here. I would forward my gesture of gratitude to jury and lovely audience. I condemn all my fellow being and I firmly stand with my opinion. Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful again, wonderful performance again, smartly presented your arguments. I would again say that. And now last but not the least is team number 12 and the participants are Priya Rana and Diya Gupta. So the team number 12 participants Priya Rana and Diya Gupta.
Good afternoon to our respected jury of judges, teachers and fellow contestants. I am Priya Rana, contestant number 12A, and today we are having a debate on the topic, online smart classes are the future education style, and I am in the motion of it. And I also have here with me my co-partner, Diya Gupta, who is against the motion. The situation of our world isn't hidden from us, yet we can't keep our education at stake. Although we have to stay at home, yet we can keep up with our education by the means of online classes. In my views, online classes are the most appropriate form of teaching as well as learning in these trying times as well as in the upcoming future. And here are some reasons why. Number one, easy to focus. Believe it or not, but a traditional classroom is always a bustling place. It is not always easy for all of us to study in such a noisy environment. But with online classes, the scenario is completely different. We can study in an empty room and focus on all our studies without getting disturbed. Plus, it helps in easy and better learning. Number two, less intensity. Taking up traditional classes means waking up super early in the morning to catch the bus, going to school, studying for 5 hours straight without many breaks, going home, doing homework, revising for the next classes, and doing it all over again the very next day. It can get pretty exhausting for our students, but with online classes, we can not worry about the catching of the bus because now we can stay at home and study at peace. We get enough breaks in between the classes, Plus, it is comparatively much less exhausting. To sum it up, online classes are of just the perfect intensity for our students. Now, lastly, self-discipline. Many people say that online classes require a lot of discipline and it is a disadvantage of it. But if we look at it in a different way, it is not necessarily a disadvantage. Let's look at it this way. While learning in online classes, we not only learn about the bookish text, but we also learn about self-discipline. Isn't that just a win-win for us? To conclude it all, I would say that online classes are far better than what we give them credit for. If we people pay as much attention in online classes as much as we do in traditional classes, then it is guaranteed that online classes will dominate the world in the near future. So I guess in the end, it is sure for us to say that online classes are indeed the future education style. Thank you.
Absolutely, Priya. We can't deny the fact that online classes have made a huge market in the field of education, as people are taking online classes as it has made them a bit easier. But I strongly object the fact that it is easy to focus during online classes, as many people get distracted easily as there's no one keeping an eye on them. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dia Gupta, code number 12B. I know my opponents have done an amazing job presenting their views, but here we go, one last time, until next time. There's some major drawbacks to e-learning, and these problems often get pushed aside in online discussions. They may teach you self-discipline, as you just said, but who can teach us the way to connect and bond with people better than our own schools? So now let's have a closer look at all these problems. Firstly, online student feedback is very limited. In traditional classrooms, teachers can give students immediate face-to-face feedback. Personalized feedback has a really, really positive impact on the students, as it makes learning process much easier and more significant. As I'm against the motion, for which I have reasons for, obviously, so I feel like discussing some of the solutions to the problems along the way. Like I just put forward the point of limited student feedback. This disadvantage of e-learning is sometimes solved through video chats with the professors. Moving on further, online instructors tend to focus on theory rather than practice, which I personally feel like is a really great challenge for the teachers and the students as well. The problem is that a large proportion of e-learning trainers choose to focus largely on developing theoretical knowledge rather than practical skills. The reason for this is pretty evident. After all, theoretical lectures are considerably easier to implement in an online learning environment than practical knowledge. Okay, now let's talk about its solution a little. Like one-to-one mentorship are some of the most effective ways of developing practical skills in online students. Lastly, I would like to talk about something that we all are pretty much aware of and is the biggest of all, and is pretty much addressed by every person I have come across, that online learning is inaccessible to the computer illiterate population. And when we particularly talk about India, for example, despite the country being one of the major players in the world of e-learning, there's still a large gap in the computer literacy in the population. Also, I'm so sorry, but I don't agree with you here saying that online classes are less tiring and people can do the things by staying in their own comfort zones, because I feel like people really can't grow when they stay in their own comfort zones, you know? And I genuinely respect the views put forward by all my worthy opponents, but I still feel like that it can never replace the real classroom fun that we all used to have earlier. And thereby stand by my opinions. Thank you so much.
Thank you, team number 11. You were both superb and very confident. Great job. Now, from team number 11, Abbas Ali, as there was some kind of disturbance over there when he was speaking, so we give you another chance with us. You can speak up again. You can come over and you can speak up again. Your entire performance, you can do it again. Abbas Ali, team number 11.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, bache. We are giving you the chance. That is, you can come up again. As there was some disturbance was there when you were speaking, so which was unavoidable. So now you can speak again.
Okay, ma'am. Necessity is the mother of invention, but everything in this world comes with a price and certain consequences. And are we ready to pay that price? Taking this into account and my fellow mates' view, I, SM Abbas Ali, Code 11B, in the presence of jury, I want to forward cutthroat opinion to my companion's view. Dear opponent, I don't know if flexibility that you meant by system was a new opportunity for students to stop killing dreams of their grandfather and grandmothers for the sake of day off and taking and giving them a new set of excuses like, sorry, my net is not working. Or on the other hand, students, I need you to submit assignment before 6 in the evening on Sundays. I hope this flexibility won't tangle things more instead. And next was technological advancement, huh? Oh my. What kind of technological advancement is this, my friend, which suddenly come in like an ad in movie theater while studying online? Quite shocking, right? To think solving value of cos theta and answer comes up dil bechara. This is one of the reason I'm opposing online system where entertainment and schooling collides. Again and again, mate, we heard in news, see ourselves about poor people and you are stating it is easily accessible. Please don't joke around. People don't get food for days. How come they will get smartphone for online studies? Leave recording aside. So let me restate it for you. Only and only accessible in urban cities. Brother, saying word to word, student getting creative learning experience. Yes, it's true. But talking about customized is seriously on the next level. Yes, students do have increased interest. I can say whether they have leaped toward studies, but I can say they have leaped down on bed for sure while online classes. It's their way of customizing, which I don't think is at all very good and a focused way of study. I partially agree with you, my friend, on economic savings in this method. But to think as a whole picture, it is definitely lacking something. Things that all the students enjoy and take benefit of in school, like manners, moral values, priceless friendship moments, and heartwarming school moments. I really don't think that any amount of money can buy all of that. Dear friends, I was not lagging. It was just a specimen of interaction that generally happens in online class. Taking time into consideration, I would like to wrap up my case here. I would forward my gesture of gratitude to jury and lovely audience. I condemn all my fellow being and I firmly stand with my opinion. Thank you.
Thank you, Abbas. Great performance. Now we are thorough with our performances. Jury, if you would like to share some words with our participants and with all of us. Jury, Mrs. Neha Gupta, Ms. Neha Gupta and Ms. Shilpa Chaudhary.
It was such a wonderful experience to hear our young learners, and it's really amazing, you know, the confidence with which they speak, the diction and, you know, the body language and the amazing points that they had put across. I think it was a great learning experience for me as well. Thank you so much. It was such a delight to be part of this event. And kudos to you, ma'am, and the school for organizing this one of its kind event. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. It was a great experience. Shilpa, ma'am.
When schools are closed due to corona, you know, it seems impossible to conduct debate competition. But there is a saying, where there is a will, there is a way. I'm really amazed at the amount and the quality of work that the teams have put together into their projects and the professionalism of their approach and presentation. It was delightful to have such a wonderful team competing with each other. Thank you, Vivekanand Public School, to give me an opportunity to be a part of such a gala event. Thank you, Nandini ma'am. Thank you, Neha ma'am.
Thank you so much, Shilpa ma'am. And so rightly said, most of the times we are always learning from these school students also, from our students as well. Now, this live event has really helped BBS to gain and share new experiences. First of all, I thank to Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. BBS would like to thank our judges for volunteering your time to judge our live event, The Talking Head. Thank you, jury. Thank you, judges, once again. And thanks to the wonderful, lovely participants, your thoughts have enlightened our minds also. I know you must be keen to know the results, but the results shall be declared in our closing ceremony, that is on 28th August. So everyone, wait for the results. They'll be declared in the closing ceremony. Now, mind is never a problem. Mindset is. If you are determined, nothing can stop you from determining your dreams. Quoting our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, we would like to wind up today's program here to meet you tomorrow at the same time, that is 12 noon, with our next live event, Beyond Borders.